PV Ekhande, working as an assistant professor in mechanical engineering department at Walchand of Technology, Solapur. So today we are going to observe the problems related with the projection of planes. At the end of this session, students will be able to complete the projections of planes by using coordinate system and to find the strike and dip of the given plane. Finding the strike and dip of the triangular plane LMN, the coordinates for that plane are given as, that is, for corner L is 40, 60 and 100. Coordinates for M, those are 60, 80 and 120. And for N, the coordinates are 80, 30 and 140. Now, as we know, these coordinates are indicating the position of point on the plane for its front view and top view. When we consider 40 millimeter, the 40 millimeter stands for the distance on x-axis, and the remaining two dimensions, that is 60 and 100, those are for y-axis. But on that y-axis, first figure, that is 60, will indicate the position of that point for the top view, and the second last figure, that is 100 mm over here, is indicating the position of the point on the plane for the front view position, that will be, as I say, LF in this case. Now we'll start solving the problem. For this, first we have to draw the coordinates x and y. So x, as we know, that is a vertical line which is to be completed, and on this vertical line the dimensions are to be marked, as I said, 10, 20, 30, 40, like this, in the increasing order we'll be marking the dimensions in the vertical upward direction. And for y-axis, the dimensions, those are to be taken in the horizontal direction. So on this horizontal line we'll be marking the distances for obtaining the positions for the first figure, that is 40 millimeter. Now for L, when we consider the point L is to be located for the front view at 40 and 60 millimeter, and the point L in the top view, that is to be indicated on that vertical line which is to be completed with respect to this 40 millimeter distance. So first step is to complete the position of L on x axis at 40 millimeter distance. Before that, just we'll mark the points in the x direction at the distances 10, 20, and then we'll locate the point on that, so that it will be better to locate the given position. So these are the points which I am marking over here at the 10 millimeter distance each. Now what is the maximum figure on the x-axis that we are going to consider from the given points? Now when we consider these three points L, M and N, in x direction the maximum figure is 80 millimeter. So N point is at 80 millimeter, M is at 60 and L is at 40 millimeter. So we will mark up to the position, say 100 maximum. So this point is at 10, 20, third is at 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 and 100. Similarly, on y-axis we have to locate the points, and for that again when we observe the corners, in that case the maximum figure given is 140 millimeter. On y-axis we have the dimension 60, 100, 80, 120 and 30, 140. So maximum dimension is 140 millimeter. So we'll mark the distance, say up to 140 millimeter in the vertical upward direction. So these points we'll mark first, so that we can directly locate the point on that y-axis. So these are the points at distance 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100, 110, 120, 130, 140, and last we can consider as a 150 millimeter. Now on these two axes, we are going to locate the points from say L corner to N corner. First we will consider L. For that the distance on x axis is 40 millimeter. So with respect to this, we will complete the line in vertical direction on which the remaining two dimensions are to be marked. So this 40 millimeter line, on that now we are going to locate the points at 60 millimeter and 100 millimeter. So those will be points for the front view and top view. Now first point is at 60 millimeter and second is at 100 millimeter. Now the first point, that is 40-60, is L in the top view. So we will call that point as a LH, and the point which is at 100 millimeter on this 40 millimeter distance line is for front view. So we will locate that point as a LF. In the same manner, we will be locating the remaining two points, that is 60, 80, 120 for M point, and for N point 80, 30 and 140. So we will locate 60 millimeter distance on X axis. And from this 60 millimeter distance, first we will complete the line in the upward direction, that is y axis direction. It is a line parallel to that on which we will be completing the positions for the two points, and those are for M point. So the points will be MF and MH. So 60, 80. So from 80 millimeter, we will draw the line parallel to X axis, which will have the intersection over here. Or we can directly locate the distance 80 over here. Now second point is 120 millimeter, at 120 millimeter distance. So for that again we'll have the line parallel from that 120 millimeter distance. Now this point is in the front view to be denoted as a MF, which is at 120 millimeter distance, and the earlier point, that is 80 millimeter distance point, that is to be denoted with the suffix H, as the point will be on top view side. So that is MH. In the same manner, we will have the locating of N point, which is at 80 millimeter on X axis. So at 80 millimeter distance, again we will draw the line parallel. On this parallel line, we will locate the points at the given distance, that is 30 is the first point. So at 30 millimeter distance, we will locate the point on this 80 millimeter line, and on the same line the another point is at 40 millimeter distance. So that point is NF for the front view position, and in the top view the point is to be located as a N suffix H, because that is the top view point. Now we will connect these three points in the top view to get the top view of plane LMN, and we will connect these three points in the front view to get the front view of, the plane LMN. In between these two views, we can draw the line FH, which is a reference line, which can be completed at approximately mid position. So this point is at 100 millimeter distance, whereas this topmost point of the top view is at 80 millimeter. In between this at 90 millimeter, then we can draw the reference line FH. So this reference line FH. Now with respect to this reference line, the necessary parameters are to be calculated. Now we will complete the top view by connecting these three corner positions. And remember that the actual plane, that is to be completed with the dark line, and the projectors which we have completed for these points, that is N, F or NH, for that obtaining it, we have first completed the line, that should be a faint line. Now when we connect these three points, we will find these three points in one line, because when we consider the difference between these two, so 20 and 20, so that has got the 45 degrees angle. Here also from this it is 20 and 20, so 45 degrees angle, so it is in one line, and that itself is becoming in this case as a edge view of the plane. Here the projection of the plane LMN in the front view has been obtained as a edge view instead of its position as a triangle, whereas in the top view we obtained that as a triangle. Now here we have to calculate or measure the front view and top view of find out the strike and dip of the plane. So strike, for that purpose we have to consider the true length line from the plane, which will indicate, which is to be indicated in the top view. And for that purpose, here when we consider the point M from which the starting line in the top view is in the true length, because here that indicates the point view. So when we consider the line in the top view starting from this, and for example we'll consider this top view intersection point as a PH, so this line is the horizontal line from the plane, which is nothing but the strike of the plane. When we consider the strike of the plane with respect to this M point, it is in the downward direction, so the strike for the plane is due south. Strike of plane is due south with respect to M point, and this is a strike line which we have obtained by considering the horizontal line from the plane. Now what is the dip? Dip is the angle made by the plane with the ground or with HRP. So this angle is dip angle. So dip angle over here is 45 degrees. So dip angle is 45 degrees. What is the dip direction? For that, when we consider the plane inclination, it has got the downward inclination in this direction with respect to the man position, which we can consider as a standing on the HRP or the ground plane. Now this plane is having downward inclination in this direction, so that is to be marked in the top view over here as a line perpendicular to strike line. So this line is dip direction of the plane. Now this dip direction of the plane is due which direction? That is due west. So dip direction is due west. So have you understood the procedure of calculation, drawing of the plane, or drawing, locating the points with the coordinate system, for which the numbers or the figures will be given, from which we can draw the location of the different points on the coordinate system? Thank you.